Meme. Right, yeah.
I know, I'm just giving
one second.
Yeah, yeah, cool. It was mine for me, innit?
Yeah. So, Allah Azza wa Jal is the only one knows about it. Even the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he didn't mention about it. And if he knew about it, he will tell it to us.
Yeah, cool.
Otherwise, if he didn't inform us about the meaning of Alif Lam Meme and he hide it, that means he hide revelation from Allah. Correct?
All right, cool.
Can he do that?
So why did he choose them? Why did he choose to give it to them? Instead of giving it to us.
There is no, again my brother, there is no choose to give them anything special. That's why my point is to you, to say that if, think about it, Islam is for everyone, yes?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Kurdish.
Kurdish. I'm from Jordan. We have some brothers from Somalia. We have some brothers from Philippines. We have some brothers from Pakistan. We have brothers all around the world.
Yeah.
Why Allah to choose only five people just to know something about the Quran and lift the whole ummah?
Yeah. It's a specialty. It says they hold the same way.
My brother hold the same way. Trust me. Think about it.
Family, they hold the same weight.
And the wives of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. No, they're not the same way.
I'm bringing a hadith right now, brother.
Listen. You could bring me all the hadith in the
dunya. So you don't believe the hadith?
Brother, I'm telling you what's the hadith, the authentic one.
This you is authentic, bring I'm showing you.
No, I will tell you, they're not the same way. He said thaqalayn, meaning the two heavy things. No problem.
The weight.
The weight. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, there is no same weight. But for you to know, there is no same weight. There is no hadith talking about equality in the weight of the family of the Quran and the Quran. There is no
equality. I'll show you right now. I'll show you right now, my brother. Look.
Okay, so you're here to debate. So you're not here to learn, you're here to debate. If you want, listen. I don't care, that's English. That's not the same
okay.
in the Prophet.
Okay, would you want to bring the Arabic?
Yeah, give me the Arabic. Where is the source? Source.
I'll bring it.
Source. Okay, I think you didn't do your homework. Listen to me. What's your name, by the way?
I'm not knowledgeable enough to know.
All right, good. If you're not knowledgeable, let me educate you, my brother. This saying, brother, this saying.
It's a saying.
These are saying, here.
It's going further on.
Okay, wait one second. There is nothing talk about their same weight.
Yes. I put on Google Translate.
But that's the problem, brother. Google, again, it doesn't mean two weight, two heavy things. It doesn't mean they're the same
weight. Okay, you're telling me the hadith that I showed you, man.
There is no hadith showed me.
I showed you, man.
By the way, you didn't show me a hadith. That's what this one.
In English translate.
This one, Sahih Tirmidhi and others. He said, "Itaqilu fiqhu ma antum lan tazal kitab Allah." Yeah, حبل من رسول السماء الأرض وعترة أهل بيتي. I left for you the book of Allah and my family. So it comes the second. So that's why they're not the same weight.
It says when I put on Google Translate, it says the same way.
My brother, I'm telling you Arabic. You do understand?
My dad knows Arabic as well.
Does anyone knows Arabic here?
No.
So you don't trust me? So do you accept him? He's Iraqi. He knows Arabic. Yeah.
Do you want to read Arabic?
He knows some Arabic.
Know how to read that. Why are you bringing it? He's saying no. He doesn't know.
No, he knows Arabic. He's Arab. Yeah. Listen. Listen. Actually this hadith goes contradict what you said. And here, this hadith in Musnad Ahmad, and this hadith in Tirmidhi and Sahih al-Albani, what he said. Listen to this. This for the Arab audience and for you. He said, "Inni tarikum fikum," I'm leave behind you. Or behind me for you. ما إن تمسكتم به, if you hold tightly upon it, لن تظلوا بعدي. You will be not going astray after me. أحدهما أعظم من الآخر. One of them is greater than the other. Yeah, that means أعظم من الآخر. كتاب الله. The book of Allah. حبل ممدود من السماء والأرض. Like a rope from the heavens to the earth. Yeah. وعترتي أهل بيتي. And my family.
Yeah.
The family, عترتي, which is my family. So he said one of them is greater than the other. So they're not the same way.
Alright, cool. Listen.
Yeah, go take it.
I put on Google Translate, it would not say the same thing.
Sahih Muslim.
لا, هذا في مسلم في الترمذي. ترمذي مسند أحمد. Hey. Why we go far? Here.
Brother,
listen.
Look.
One second. I will show you.
Said, hello. I'm saying the same thing.
I will show you. No.
I'm only human being, the messenger of Allah, so I'll answer to you. There are two weights. The first of which is the book of God, and which is guidance, the light, and the book of God, and hold it fast to it. He has the book of God and Zad. Then he said, my family.
Yeah.
The same weight.
No, they're not the same weight. Here, this is, that's another website which is already translated, yeah? أحدهما أعظم من ال... Okay. This hadith, yeah? This hadith that you're talking about, yeah?
I don't know. I can't read Arabic.
No, the Arabic one, the one you showed me just earlier.
Yeah.
No, the Arabic one. The Arabic one. Yeah, the Arabic one. Come on. Come on. The Arabic one. Come on. The Arabic one here. You see here, this one. Here.
Yeah.
Yeah. أحدهم عظم الخير. Yeah. Here. This one. Yeah. إني تاركم فيكم ما تمسكتم. I'm leaving for you. What if you hold? لن تظلوا. You're going to be not misguided after. أحدهم أعظم الآخر. One of them is greater than the other. The translation, brother. Yeah. Here. Where is it? Here. One of them is greater than the other. One of them is greater than the other.
Okay, go on.
You agree?
Yeah, go on.
Yeah, go on. I'm here. One of them. The book of Allah is a rope extended from the sky to the earth, which is this one. And my family, the people of my house, they shall not split until they meet me at the Hawd.
Let me take a picture.
Okay. Now, since we demonstrate that one of them is greater than the other. Yeah? We demonstrate this. So they're not equal. So.
When I read it, it says it from
that. Yeah, that's why you don't read what you think. You read what is there.
Bro, did I not say that in Google Translate though?
I said, but that's not all. Again, my brother, I'm advising you to read. Google Translate is not always the right translation. Yeah? So always, that's why, especially in terms of Islamic terms, we need a special translation.
All right.
So now, one of them is greater than the other. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay? Now the next step now here. Since one of them is greater than the other, we're talking about what? The book of Allah. Yeah. The book of Allah is the greatest. Yeah? Then after that, which is the guidance and of course the sayings and the guidance of the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That includes what? Include what? Is it only the people of the Kisa? Is only the people under the cover? Or all the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? It means all the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And approved as well throughout the history as well, even from Ali radiyallahu anhu, when he used to consult his uncle, Al-Abbas. So that shows as well, there is something as well that the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has a status. Yeah? And that's why, my brother, you should understand, which means if there is a unanimous agreement of the family of the Prophet ﷺ upon something, we agree with it. It doesn't go against Islam, against Quran. But if there is differences between them in terms of saying, then in that case, because they're not infallible. You understand? That means they're not infallible. Allah
has... They know the secrets.
My brother, there is no hadith talking about the secrets. And I'm here again advising you, there is no single hadith talking about there are special secrets. The Quran is an open book for everyone to understand. There are certain things Allah challenged the Arabs to bring a book which is from these letters. But here these letters, only Allah knows them, even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So there is no special education for special people and the others. That means it's injustice. And we are in this case, you are accusing Allah or accusing the Prophet of Allah to be unjust. Which is totally wrong. Allah Azza wa Jalla is just and Allah is merciful. Allah wanted the guidance for us. So these secrets, are they important or not important? Why Allah didn't teach us about them if they are important? What? You think?
Because if it just gives it to
is it important? No. It's Islam is given to everyone, my brother. It's not for special people. You see here, I'm advising you just to use your rational thinking. Yeah? Now, if it's important in Islam, if there's something very important, do you think Allah will hide it from us? So Allah will expose it, will tell us. So that means there is no special things, my brother. And people who lied to you, they said, the Quran has special secrets. Only certain people knows it and other people don't know it. Those are liars. Quran is an open book to be understood, to be implemented, to be followed. Is an open book to be followed and to be understood. It's not for special people and other people not. Because we believe Allah's justice. Allah's just and Allah's fair and Allah's merciful and Allah loves the guidance for us. Allah loves us. How Allah will favor certain people, give them certain things and the other not. That's exactly what the Shia are saying. That's exactly what the extreme Sufis are saying. The peers. Some peers, you know, in Pakistan and in Egypt, in all around the world, you'll find they call them peers. Who are they? Those, they said they know the secrets of the Quran. Subhanallah. Who brought you these secrets? They said, something, it's a relationship, special relationship between us and Allah. Who gave you this special relationship? Who gave you that? Allah didn't affirm this in the Quran. Allah didn't say this in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Where you got it from? So that's why my brother, from the fairness of Islam, and from the justice of Islam, and from the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah Azza wa Jal revealed the Quran. There are certain things Allah Azza wa Jal revealed it to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yeah, and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah Azza wa Jal said to him, Ya ayyuha nabi, balligh ma unzila ilaykum rabbi. Convey what has been revealed to you from your Lord.
Okay. You know that seerah. Says the book of Allah is a rope from the
sending
from the sky to the earth.
Yes.
And my family.
Yes. Do you understand
what I said? People of my house and they shall not split.
Yes. Do you know what means this?
Until they meet at Hawad. So look at how you deal with them after me.
You know what it means?
What?
My brother, you know
you
what it means?
You only give me half the soul. Where's the rest?
That's the rest. That's the whole of it.
That's the whole thing.
Wallah, that's the whole thing.
Yeah, but still, it still says.
Yeah, that's
it. Alright, cool. It says the book of Allah.
Listen.
The sky and my family.
Our initial. And my listen, family. Listen.
So where does it say one is better than the other?
Here. Read.
Where does it say?
One of them is greater than the other. That was the idea to bring this hadith. One of them is greater than the other. Yeah? Because you said they are not greater, they're the same. I said to you, no, one of them is greater than the other. And this hadith you brought to me earlier, and I brought to you the translation of it. So one of them is greater than the other.
Okay.
They shall not split, meaning their understanding to the Quran and the Sunnah as a unanimous agreement between the family of the Prophet, it goes with the Quran and Sunnah, no problem. That's what it means.
So whatever they say,
no, not individually, whatever they agreed upon, then yes.
Yeah.
That includes the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, include the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, include the cousins of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then yes. Not only Hassan, Hussein, and Ali, and Fatima. Radiyallahu anhu.
I don't know who the 12 or the
that's why. Why do you confuse yourself? They will bring a hadith. They will bring a vague hadith to say to you, they're gonna be 12 leaders from Quraysh.
Khalifa,
from Quraysh.
Yeah. We don't know who it is though.
Vague. You know what means this? 12 leaders, firstly political leaders.
Yeah.
Now the question is, was Ali Zain al-Abidin, Sajjad, was he a political leader?
I don't know, I'm not knowledgeable enough.
He's not, he wasn't. During the time. Was Musa al-Kadhim, Ja'far al-Sadiq, none of them was a political leader.
So he was?
That's my point. Meaning they were Quraysh, but not necessarily from the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the meaning of the hadith from Quraysh,
okay.
Not necessarily from only the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Let me see the hadith.
Brother.
But the hadith, brother.
No. Huh? Can you be Sunni and have them beliefs? Are you still Sunni if you have them beliefs?
If he believes that those are special people, special people, and Allah give them this, no.
It's not.
No. Yeah. If he believes that those are special people. And Allah give them secret knowledge, and they are in control of certain things, and they are in charge of the, you know, of the judgment in the day of judgment, and they are in charge of the world, and things like that. That he may commit al-'iyadu billah shirk. So be careful, my brother. Brother, we are advising you to come back to Islam, to the true Islam. Allah, seriously,
I'm not joking.
You've been misled, my brother. You fell into shirk al-'iyadu billah without knowing. So that's why, my brother, Islam is so simple and straightforward. Quran, authentic Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, simple as that.
Yeah.
And the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam included the saying and the tradition of the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the direct family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You understand? And of course, we respect Muhammad al-Baqir, rahimahullah, was a great scholar of Islam. Yeah, no problem. But at the same time, he's not infallible. We don't believe that they are infallible. They don't make mistakes. They are preserved, protected. They are not like that. They make mistakes, as anyone makes mistakes, including Ali radiallahu, including Hassan and Hussein. And some people, they say, what's the proof that Hussein committed sin, or he committed, like say, a mistake? Let alone sin, a mistake. They said, he went to die. Someone went to die. He knew that. They say he knows ilm al-ghayb, he knows. They say Hussein, he knows what's going to happen to him. And yet he went forward. So if you know you're going to, if you go this path, you're going to be killed. Will you go? If you go this path, and you know you're definitely going to be killed. Definitely you're going to be killed. Will you go?
Well, if it's for Allah.
Listen, Allah doesn't want us to die. Yeah? Allah wants us to live for His sake. You understand? Allah wants us to live for His sake, firstly. The jihad is not, the purpose of jihad is not to die. The purpose of jihad to bring Islam, to protect Islam. So to live.
No, my brother.
My brother, that's why Islam, if there is something, we don't believe in suicide missions, because at the end of the day it's haram. Because it's a definite killing to yourself, and that's haram, that's not from Islam. So that's, you need to understand, my brother, Islam based on the idea, jihad basically, if you want to protect Islam, you got to protect Islam. If you try your best to protect Islam to the best of your ability, and then if you die in that cause, that is something else. That's totally different. No.
I'm not talking about blowing yourself.
No. Yeah. So Hussein, when he went to Karbala, did he know that he's going to die there?
Yeah.
He knew.
Yeah.
So that's suicide. Do you understand the difference?
I don't think that's suicide.
Yeah, that's what it means.
I don't think it's suicide.
That's what you think.
I don't think.
Listen, my brother. Let's use our own reasoning, yeah? Allah, and the proof is that He Himself, He said to His killers, He said, you know what? Let me go to my cousin Yazid and let me speak to him.
Go on.
Allow me to do that. They said, no. If you don't allow me to do that, send me to the front lines to defend Islam and fight for the sake of Islam, defend Islam. Send me there. They refused. He said, let me go back to Medina. That's a go back where I came from. So he didn't choose to die. Do you understand the point? So that's why to say he went and he knew that he's going to die, that's suicide. So that's why he didn't know that he's going to die, firstly. So because he doesn't know the ghaib. He thought that he's going to bring goodness to the ummah, which is true. He has a point to say this. But my point is to you that he never said, he never went to die. And the purpose of jihad in Islam is not to die. The purpose of Islam is to protect and to bring life to the people, not to die. You understand? That's a totally different thing. People die in the battlefield, no problem. But the idea is to protect and to give lives to the people.
What's this? To save soul from hell and then go to paradise.
What? Who's this? Are you talking to your dad?
It's his father, yeah. He's Sunni, but
I'm gonna get back to you, don't worry.
I don't want you to get back to me. I want you to get back to yourself. Yeah, not to me.
You,
it's not about me. You now here, you are the one who could go to hellfire with this understanding, or you are the one who could go to Jannah if you follow the right path. It is you, not me. You are not here. I'm not here to debate you, my brother. I want the goodness for you. Wallahi, I'm here. Wallahi, I want the guidance for you, my brother.
I'm gonna debate you until we get to the bottom.
Listen, debating, by the way, if the debate will bring you the truth, I have no problem.
Yeah.
But the problem is, I don't want you to be staunch and just to follow.
I'm hearing from both sides, brother.
Okay.
I don't want to just hear from one side. What do you want me to do? Just hear from one side. Come on, man.
Now, did I prove to you what is the Quran has no special secrets for
no,
certain
people?
I said this to you now.
You said it, but you didn't prove it to me.
I prove it with your own reasoning. How? Allah says in the Quran, we have sent a Quran al-Mubin, a clear, obvious Quran. So it's obvious, Mubin, clarifying. Mubin, clear and clarifying, meaning the message is clear and clarifying for others. Yes?
Yeah.
And Allah says in the Quran, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This book has no doubt, هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It is guidance for those who seek piety, who wants piety. So it's guidance, my brother. So it's not secret. Do you understand the difference?
Yeah. He tells me.
Did I prove to you now?
Hold on, I'm gonna get back to you, don't worry.
I'm not worried, I'm worried for you. I'm not worried about myself, I'm worried for you.
I'm gonna get back to you, man.
No problem, I'm worried for you. My brother, Islam is so simple and so straightforward. Quran, the book of Allah as it is, an obvious, clear message from Allah. The Sunnah, authentic Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, to follow it, the guidance of Muhammad ﷺ. We honor, we respect the family of the Prophet ﷺ, and we say they are above our heads. No problem. But we don't believe they are infallible. We don't believe that they are ma'soom, they don't make mistakes. We believe they have the ijtihad, they could be right, they could be wrong. No problem. That's how we deal with them, my brother. You understand?
Yeah, my brother.
I'm thinking, I'm going to ask, is it okay to go to the shrine of Hussein?
No, it's not allowed to go to the shrine.
Explain to why.
Shrine is a shirk. Going to these shrines are shirk.
I make a tawassul.
That is shirk. my brother.
So when they done it when the Prophet was alive?
Who?
They didn't do it when the Prophet was alive?
Yes, when if the Prophet was alive, do that. But if he's after his death, there is no one to do to tawassul
to. Do you want me to go, this Prophet, this family of Prophets still to this day?
Who is more merciful, Allah or his messenger?
Allah.
So you think the messenger will listen to you and Allah will not listen to you?
So
I'm asking,
Allah, would Allah listen to me or Allah listen to the messenger?
Allah will listen to you because
more than
Allah
the messenger.
I will tell you why. I will tell you why.
Come on, brother.
Listen to me. I'm here. Let's try to listen. Can you leave the texting? Because you can't focus.
Yeah.
Focus. Yeah. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive, the Sahaba used to go and ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make dua to them. No problem. That's happening. It happened. Because he's alive. Of course, Allah will listen to him more and his dua will be more acceptable than the dua of the Sahaba. No problem. But after he died, alayhi salatu wasalam, so then they used to go to who? They said, Umar al-Khattab, one day they did istisqa. And he said, oh Allah, istisqa means asking rain. He said, oh Allah, in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we used to seek rain through the dua of your Prophet. Now after he died, we are seeking rain through the dua of his uncle, Al-Abbas.
Yeah.
Meaning, but they didn't say through the Prophet, they didn't go to his grave and ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You understand the difference? So that's why the tawassul, my brother, is the tawassul which is lawful in Islam, is either through Allah's names and attributes. Yeah? And Allah loves you more than your mother. So Allah Azza wa Jal will not leave your dua. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Allah Azza wa Jal is shy. Shy, if you raise your hand to him like this and asking him, Allah is shy to leave this hand empty. Allah will give you something. Either will grant you what you ask, or will give you something better, or focus with me. Or will give you something better than that in the hereafter. The other thing, you could ask through Allah's names and attributes. You could do that. Or you could ask if the Prophet was alive, or someone who is pious, you think he is good and making dua for you, not someone peers or whatever, someone who follow the Quran and Sunnah to say, make dua for me, no problem. Yeah? But your dua for yourself is better than someone who's pious to you. Thirdly, you could make dua to Allah through the best deed that you have done. And there is the best deed that if you love Allah and His Messenger, say, oh Allah, answer my dua. Because I love you and I love your Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. If you make this dua, Allah will accept your dua. Because you are seeking the wasila. Which wasila? Through the love of Allah and His Messenger and the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. No problem. You could do that. You could say, oh Allah, I ask you that I testify there is that you are the only one worthy to be worshipped. No problem.
Okay,
you could make
okay,
dua.
One second. If they come after the Quran,
who?
You say, wherever you said the hadith, it says one is better than the other.
Greater
than the other.
Yeah.
So you're saying after the Quran, the basic family of Rasulullah. Isn't that what it's saying? Yes or no?
I will tell you what it means. Akhi, it has meaning. Meaning the family of the Prophet as individuals or as a whole. As a whole, yes. Individuals, my brother, as individuals, some of them make mistakes, some of them they could be right, some of them they could be wrong. It doesn't matter. But as a whole, yes.
Okay.
You understand
so
me?
That means they know the best.
No,
it does.
The Quran, this hadith.
They know the Quran the best because they my the Quran
again.
Comes them.
My
they
brother.
Know the Quran the best.
My brother. It is in the hadith. They didn't say they know the Quran best. It didn't say this.
Okay, but if they come after the Quran,
this is your conclusion.
You say one's greater than the other.
Yeah.
So why they bring a number?
Okay.
Four?
Allah's Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. For example, Abdullah bin Abbas. He was the most knowledgeable one of the Quran.
Okay.
Not Ali.
I don't know this.
Yeah, now you know.
Now you're learning.
Abdullah ibn Abbas, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was named by the Sahaba Turjuman al-Quran. You know what means Turjuman al-Quran? The interpreter of the Quran.
Brother,
he was known with this.
Have you got the book, you know, Science and the Quran?
Well, maybe find it here.
Yeah. And was he not the family?
Yeah.
Was he not part?
No.
Yeah, he was family.
So, as a family, as a whole, if they are under, no problem. But to say individuals.
I didn't say individuals.
Yeah. So, of course, my brother, the truth doesn't go outside the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Meaning, his wives, the Aisha and Hafsa, yeah. They were fuqaha, as well Ali and Fatima and Al-Hassan and Al-Hussein and Al-Abbas and Abdullah ibn Abbas and Fadl ibn Abbas. All of them, they are the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Meaning, if they unanimously agreed on something, then no problem, we accept this. Do you understand the point?
Yeah.
So that's why we don't say, oh, the truth is with them. No, not necessarily. Do you understand?
They know the best. They know the most.
My brother, the best or the most or this, it didn't indicate in a hadith. But we know, generally, of course, they are the best ones in terms of the in terms of having the knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah. No problem.
Yeah.
Along with the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Along with the Sahaba, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, as well, that the best person after the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam is Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman, then Ali. And even debate between scholars of Islam that Uthman, the comparison between Uthman and Ali, they said some of them, some of the scholars, they said Ali is better than Uthman or vice versa. But in overall, they agree on this. And who said this? The judge Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah was a judge during Ali time, and he said, Wallahi, I saw Ali, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali رضي الله عنه, climbing this member. And he was saying, the best people of this ummah after its prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Abu Bakr than Umar. This is the statement of who?
Does it say that in the hadith?
My brother, we don't take one hadith and ignore thousands.
No,
it's not like this.
I'm talking about the hadith that you showed me.
This does hadith again. That hadith, my brother again. This hadith, we're not talking about in terms of the heaviness of the truth. We're not talking about that. We're talking about as individuals. Abu Bakr is better than Ali.
What does it say in the hadith you showed me?
In the hadith of Ali رضي الله عنه, he said this.
Brother, the hadith that you showed me, does it say that?
Okay.
Show me the hadith.
I will use your analogy. Let's use your analogy.
I'm not knowledgeable enough to talk about it.
I'm using your analogy, yeah? It says the truth is in within the family of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah? Ali and Al-Hasan Al-Hussein, yes?
Yeah, go on.
Ali al-Hassan al-Hussein, yeah? And generally the family of the Prophet and his wife. All of them unanimously agreed that Abu Bakr is the best person after the Prophet. I will tell you how.
Show it to me.
Okay. The hadith of Ali.
Show me.
Okay.
Show me. And I'll take it.
Fine.
I'll come back to you. Still have
Come, brother. Yeah. Okay. حدثنا سفيان بن عيينة عن أبي إسحاق عن عبيد عن عبد خير عن علي رضي الله عنه أنه قال خير هذه الأمة بعد نبيها أبو بكر وعمر رضي الله عنه.
Let me take a picture, baby, brother. Let me take a picture, man.
Read now.
One second.
Don't put the flash. Now, read. He said the best of this ummah after Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم are Abu Bakr and Umar. This is who said this? Ali رضي الله عنه. Yeah?
And is this Sahih?
Yes, it's Sahih Hadith.
Sahih?
Yes, Sahih Hadith. And another Hadith here. As with another hadith. Yeah? And another hadith. And another hadith. So we have many hadith, my brother. Yeah? Now we have this hadith. So what does that tell you? What does that tell you, my brother? What does that tell you?
Okay, but then the hadith I showed you tells you different.
No, that's why the difference.
It tells you different. There's two things I left behind, the Quran and my family. And now you're telling me, Ali said, after the Prophet, after okay. They don't matter.
Because.
How?
Listen. Hmm? Listen, I think, I just wanted to ask you, just for curiosity, what's your level of education?
Zero.
That's a problem. Because zero.
That's why I want
to
get.
Yeah. Because zero. You need to educate. You need to lift up your level. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is talking about the Quran, he's talking about the truth, etc. Meaning, which means if the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam unanimously agreed on something, then it is considered to be true. That's what it means. As a whole, not as individual. But when it comes to individual person, Abu Bakr is better than Ali. Do you understand? And Umar. After him.
You're just contradicting yourself.
That's not contradiction. Because, again, that's why...
Why would you leave?
Because the problem is...
As well? Why didn't you say the Sahaba?
By the way, there is another hadith. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, as well, in another hadith, as well, he said, عليكم بسنتي, follow my sunnah. وَسُنَّةُ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيَنَ بَعْدِي Follow the sunnah of the rightly guided khalif after me. Those are Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali.
So why is Ali in there?
Ali is one of them.
Yeah, so you're trying to...
Yeah, my point is Abu Bakr is the first one, then Umar, then Uthman, then Ali. So you see here, so you should understand as well, when the Prophet ﷺ is talking about the truth, no problem, we take the truth from the family of the Prophet ﷺ, and we take the truth from the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ, no problem. But when it comes to individuals, that is something else. The Prophet ﷺ, is the best person عليه الصلاة والسلام, and the best person of his ummah after him is Abu Bakr.
I thought you were saying if someone can come after me, Muhammad Rasulullah said if someone, a prophet can come after me, it would be Ali.
Yes.
So why would he say Umar is better than Ali? Why didn't he say that about Umar?
And as well he said about Ali, about Umar, for you to know, and he said in another hadith for Umar,
yeah,
he said if there is a messenger in this ummah after me will be Umar.
But
that's
you
another hadith
about Ali. Come on.
Yeah, that you should know how we take this ahadith.
One second, okay.
Why are you running like this? I mean, you be calm and calm down. By the way, let's focus. Focus with me. All right, I think I need to conclude with you because you don't want to listen.
Brother, I'm listening.
Do you want to listen?
I'm
not here to, you can't listen to many people in the same time.
No, my brother, you're contradicting yourself.
So the point is, the Prophet ﷺ did, in the past, did it happen that there is two prophets in the same time? It happened. The prophets of Bani Israel, they used to be in the same time. Ibrahim alayhi salam and Lut alayhi salam, they used to be in the same time, correct? Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ishaq alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam, they used to be prophets in the same time. So the point is, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam indicated about the truth that they could be those ones, but there is no prophet after him. There is no messenger after him. He ended. Meaning that it could be for either of them or both of them, no problem. But Allah Azza wa Jal said he is the last and the final prophet.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
So that's how it is. So the meaning of the Prophet, he said, yeah, you, it doesn't mean only you. Yeah? But in the same time as well, that shows his favors to Islam. That shows he's great in the sight of Allah. No problem. But it doesn't make him a greater status than Abu Bakr and Umar. According to him.
Yeah, brother. All right, cool. I'll get back to you now. Don't worry. I'll get back to
you. My brother, I ask Allah to guide you firstly to the right path.
Who's recording this stuff?
But it was recorded from the beginning. So, my brother, I ask Allah to guide you to the right path, first of all. Look at me. Share me. May Allah guide us to the right path.
Inshallah,
ameen. Ameen, not inshallah, ameen. And as well, I ask Allah to show you the truth and to make you to follow the truth. My brother, if you wanted to find the truth and to look for the truth, in two things. Firstly, you need to open your mind and heart to the truth. Secondly, you need to free yourself from all kind of shirk or indication for shirk. That including tawassul with other than Allah Azza wa Jal. And it could lead you to shirk wal'iyadu billah. So be careful from this, my brother. Wallahi, be careful from this.
Don't worry, I'm going to come back to you. Don't worry.
I want you to come back to yourself, not to me.
I'm going
to
come back to you.
To yourself.
Brother.
If you want to go, because I'm not here just only, I'm here. Do you know, I generally don't like to debate Shias. Because for a reason, for me, they don't want to listen. And I'm not here to just to
do it. Bro, but you're contradicting yourself. And I'm not going to, listen, if I knew everything, I wouldn't be doing this back and forth thing. You know what I mean?
Because my brother, I have debated Shias here. And unfortunately, both of them, they have the same level. They don't have knowledge of Islam properly. They don't have knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah properly.
Why do you come at me to come to debate?
Who?
I come to debate because I don't know knowledge.
That's why.
Why do you think I come?
Now, I'm here.
If I need knowledge,
and I was,
why would I come?
My aim was to educate you, not to debate you.
Okay,
there's a difference.
Come on.
That was my aim.
Okay.
And I wish that I have educated you about something.
Inshallah.
Yeah? Look after yourself, my brother. May Allah guide you. And Allah al-musta'an. May Allah Azza wa Jal guide us to the right path. May Allah barak fik. Assalamu alaikum. كيف حالك؟ الله يبارك. محمد. خليني بس اخلص معه واجي اخلص الكاميرا واجيك دقيقة. جزاكم الله خير اخوان. And my brothers and sisters. May Allah reward you and bless you all. And may Allah increase us all in Al-Jannah. And may Allah guide our brother, inshallah, to the true faith of Islam, to the right way of Islam, the path of Allah and His Messenger, alayhi salatu wa salam. And that's what we want, inshallah. When the guidance from Allah Azza wa Jalla.
Yeah, 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 yeah. I was going to say, one quick question. Didn't Umar say the same thing about Ali as well?
There is no, I don't know. I don't know.
So exactly, brother.
I don't know if he said this about Ali.
All right. So if I bring you the proof, then what?
No, I didn't hear any Umar.
All right, all right.
By the way, and for you to know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well, for you to know, the Sahaba used to praise each other, no problem.
Yeah.
My point is, praising the Sahaba, this is according to their ijtihad, their understanding. So that's why when we are using this, we're not saying this is what Allah Azza wa Jal, what Allah revealed. So that's why, what is in your mind? You think Ali is infallible. You think Ali, all, not you, you've been influenced. No, no, no one knows the secret of the Quran except what is there in the Quran. The Quran has no secret. The Quran is open book to be understood, to be followed. Open book. There are certain places that Allah knows about them, and Allah, for a reason, didn't want to tell us about it.
Okay.
That's all. And now, those are not secret. These are not, again, Alif Lam Mim. Those are not Allah, again. The scholars, yeah, they're not secrets.
So why the
Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Azza wa Jal wanted to challenge the Arabs, to say to them, this Quran was revealed through these letters, and challenge the Arabs with their language, which the Quran is made from these letters, or is compiled with these letters. That's all. That's how it is. So there is no secrets in the Quran. It's obvious to be open, to be followed, to be interpreted, to be understood. Anyways, okay, now my brothers, may Allah reward you all, bless you all. May Allah increase us all in knowledge and iman. And may Allah guide our brother to Islam, to the true Islam, as we believe, unfortunately, in the tashayyu, the way that it is. Wallah al-musta'an is basically not Islam. It's totally away from Islam. The one who believes that the 12 imams, that they have the knowledge of the ghaib, that they are in charge of the universe, that they are in charge of the Day of Judgment, and all of these things, declaring takfir of the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, accusing the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with fornication and haram and all of these things, this, all of it is not from Islam. So we are inviting you to the true faith of Islam, and we are calling you to the true faith of Islam, which is Islam, the same Islam, and the same Quran, the same Sunnah, which was revealed upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah guide us all and show us the right path and makes us to follow it. And the guidance is showing the truth, and as well leading to the truth, and as well keep us firm upon the truth. May Allah, we ask Allah to guide us all. Jazakumullah khairan. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika nashhadu